Well, Mark, you looked in trouble tonight at 3-0 down, but came back very strongly.
Yeah, I made a good break in the fourth frame. It's really settled me down because I felt like I was being limited to half chances, and you know, Stuart was very much so on top. But it just seemed to turn a little bit after the interval. I left a plant in frame 5 and I managed to make 108, I think it was, from it. So all of a sudden, from being 3-0 and completely out of the game, it was 3-2 and it was back game on. So I felt like I played better today than I have been playing the last couple of tournaments, but still much to improve on. But very, very happy to win that, because Stuart's a very, very tough competitor.
Fair to say, when any player's 3-0 down, he's got to show a lot of guts to hang in there. Is that maybe the type of match a few years ago you wouldn't have been able to do that?
I've got a big gut, Ivan, so I've got plenty of that. So look, I've been fighting myself a lot in recent times. Not so much in the last lot of years, but in recent months. Just been fighting myself a lot when I'm out there. And just with a lot of chatting to Terry on the phone the last week or two, I'm in a better place out there now. I'm still not where I want to be, don't get me wrong, but no, I'm giving it my all, and hopefully what happened in Cheltenham will be just a complete one-off.
And do you feel you can keep that momentum going now for the rest of the season?
Well, I hope so. I feel like I'm slowly coming into form, so if I can keep going that way and keep improving, match on match, then I'd be excited about my chances in Sheffield.
And usually snooker crowds are so well behaved, so it's quite noticeable tonight. There was one person shouting out quite a lot when you were down on the shot.
Oh, what an idiot. Nothing to do with Stuart at all, but he was a bit overzealous. I don't know whether he had too much to drink, but it just seemed to be every time I was down on a shot, he was shouting things, and any time I missed, he was clapping and he was laughing. And he should have been through it a lot earlier than what he was. I think he got through it after frame 8, but the guys, the security guys, do a great job. So just wish they had seen him a bit earlier.
And Saturday night, either Ronnie O'Sullivan or John Higgins, that's going to be a massive occasion.
Of course, no matter who gets through there. Two of the probably best three of all time, in my opinion, with Henry jammed in between. Look, it's going to be a classic between them two, so let them slug it out. And then I know I'm going to have to perform against whoever comes through on Saturday night, but I'm still here and I've still got a chance.
Well done, Matt.
Thank you, man.